We are talking to Jeff Fenech all the way from Australia. Now, Jeff, last week you made international headlines. Are you aware of that?
Yeah, I think so. About Mike Tyson, yeah?
Yes. You used to, let me tell people. So you also coached Mike Tyson. In fact, Billy Dib, I interviewed him last week. He told me that you took Billy for his 21st birthday for 6 weeks to be in camp with Mike. So first of all, before we get to the controversy of whatever, what was it like? How did you end up becoming Mike Tyson's coach?
I became very, very close friends with Mike when I fought on the undercard with Mike and Ray Zoradic. And then, you know, I was always around Mike and we'd done some pad work together just at his house. And we'd done lots of things together. We ran together and we became very, very close. And then one day I get the call. You wouldn't believe it. I was in a church. I was at a baptism. I get a call. It was from America. It was from Mike Tyson. So I left the church and he said that he'd like me to come over and do some work with him. So I obviously stayed for the christening, jumped on a plane the next day, was in America and working with Mike Tyson, one of the highlights of my life. And listen, I want to go back and just say, yeah, you keep going with it. I want to bring something else up.
I'm listening. What are you going to bring up?
So today, again, I used to be a real Teddy Atlas fan. I used to like Teddy because he said it from the heart. But to hear some of the things that he said about Mike recently and, you know, that he wouldn't be in the top 10. He's like, let me go and tell you one thing. A fit and will Mike Tyson could have beat anybody, could have beat Ali, could have beaten them all. I know, I've been around them, I've been around boxing for a long time. Listen, fame and fortune change everybody. The only person that really beat Mike Tyson was Mike Tyson himself. And today when I was reading this stuff about Mike that Teddy Atlas just said, it really upsets me because, like I said, Teddy's a part of the industry. He's a part of a great, great sport. And Mike's most probably one of the most loved fighters in history. Listen, I'll tell you something about, I was at the, I'm not sure what casino was at, but we're talking about getting punched in the face and not liking it. Well, I was there when Teddy Atlas ran up into the grandstand to have a fight with somebody. He got punched once and was knocked out cold, asleep on the chairs at a stadium. So, I mean, if you want to talk about getting knocked out or this and that, you know, there are stories about this, but there are some things, and like I said, even if you know stories about people, you keep them to yourself, and for me, he's too out there, and listen, like I said, he's already been hit the mouth once. I've seen him asleep on the chairs.
Why did Teddy Atlas, but Jeff, why did Teddy Atlas get in a fight in the first place?
Apparently, there was this reporter, you've got to find the story, it was a true story, so there was a reporter there that had been arguing with him. And he ran up the stairs. And he ran up the stairs to fight with this guy. Once, just put him to sleep.
Hold on one second.
Yep.
Jeff, hold on.
What's his name? So she barked.
She heard Teddy Atlas' name and she got into security. So he got into it with some reporter. They were arguing, or?
Yeah. Apparently the reporter had written something about him, and Teddy went to jump, ran up the stairs, the chairs to front him, and the guy hit him on the chin. It was finished. It was like Teddy was having a little sleep.
So you're in camp with Mike Tyson. Sometimes I ask trainers, what did you learn from your fighters? Now, you're a three-time world champion, so obviously you come in knowledgeable, you come in with Olympic experience. Is there anything you learned from Mike when he was a fighter? You're like, wow, I wish I knew that when I was a fighter?
Yeah, you know what? You learn from everybody, and the greatest thing that I learned, Elie, was that everybody's different. You've got to treat every fighter differently. You've got to treat every fighter as individual. Some people can do certain things like you can scream and yell at some fighters, and you've got to be really nice to other fighters because they can't handle that kind of pressure. So, you know, I learned that over the years, like training all the time, that not everybody can train like Jeff Fenech did, or not everybody can punch like Mike Tyson. You've got to treat them all differently. They're all individuals, and that's the one thing I did learn about. And I learned a lot from Emmanuel Stewart. Emmanuel Stewart, for me, was maybe the greatest teacher of a boxer in the history of the sport because he was just so knowledgeable.
No, and a very nice guy too, very generous.
Very much. Very beautiful man.
So you said, and I'm going to quote you, that if Mike Tyson has a training camp, you said for 5 weeks, is that correct?
Longer than that, seven weeks.
Let's say eight weeks, 2 months. Mike Tyson has a training camp in 2 weeks, and he gets in the ring to fight, let's say, Tyson Fury. What happens?
Now listen, for me, Tyson Fury can fight. He's one of those guys who's going to have a plan. He'll be able to tie you up, lean on you, and that kind of stuff. So, I mean, at this age, that's a tough fight for Mike. Like I said, Deontay Wilder. I mean, this guy, if you punch him once, obviously I've watched this guy and I've watched him closely. Listen, look at the fights that he wins that he's just been, you know, really, I mean, all that people get excited because he knocks somebody out. It's as boring as dog shit. I mean, you're just watching. I fall asleep here in Australia watching the fight, and then all of a sudden he lands one punch. That wouldn't happen with Mike. Mike would be putting pressure on him, make him punch. As soon as he missed Mike once and Mike hit him, the fight would be over. I would train Mike tomorrow and think that he could beat Wilder. Tyson Fury, you've got a tough fight because this guy's big, he's clever, he's smart. He's got a game plan.
I will say this. If Wilder does land on Mike Tyson, it may be a short fight because Wilder has that power that's a game changer.
If lands on anybody, it's a game changer. But can he land before Mike?
It's possible. What if he catches him coming in?
But he doesn't look like a confident fighter to me. He's always waiting. Mike's not gonna let them people who wait for Mike get knocked out.
Well, it's a fight obviously we'll never see, but it'll be interesting. What about this? Anthony Joshua, Mike Tyson.
Now, again, I just think that, Mike, has it over these guys. I just think that he's pressure. Again, like I said, I'm talking about a fit Mike. I'm talking about the Mike Tyson who fought Razor Ruddy. Those were not the guy who fought Lennox. Listen, Lennox is a great fighter. And Evander, for me, is one of the greatest fighters in the history of the sport.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Elie Seckbach.